Let's discuss the development of palate. Again, a favorite question for the examiners. It's actually a very small topic, but you should know the points which you have to stress when you write the development of palate. So before going straight into the development of palate, let's see the development of face. I've already done the session on development of face. Please go through it. This process which is developing from above, it is called the frontonasal process, and from the lateral aspect we have the maxillary process. So these two major processes are giving rise to the formation of palate, the frontonasal process and the maxillary process. Frontonasal process actually again further divided into a medial nasal process and lateral nasal process. So all these terminologies you should be familiar with when we discuss about the development of palate. Now the development of palate, we can consider it as derived from two parts, the primary palate and the secondary palate. The primary palate and the secondary palate. So what is primary palate, or from which part it is derived? So primary palate is actually formed by the fusion of the two medial nasal processes which are derived from the frontonasal process. So this portion is called the fused medial nasal processes. That is from which we have the development of primary palate. So hope you all know the view which I have drawn here. This is actually a section which is passing like this, a horizontal plate or a horizontal section. When we take at this region, we can see that the anteriormost part we have the frontonasal process, and on either side you have the maxillary process. So frontonasal process anteriorly, and on lateral side we have the maxillary process. So this is actually a horizontal section which I have drawn here. So frontonasal process, the medial nasal processes which fuse in the midline, actually makes a prolongation posteriorly. This process is called primary palate, and this primary palate is giving rise to a part known as premaxilla. And this premaxilla will be having four incisors. That is a peculiarity of premaxilla. So premaxilla is actually a posterior prolongation from the primary palate, which is derived from the two fused medial nasal processes, which are again derived from the frontonasal process. So that is the primary palate. Now what do you mean by the secondary palate? Secondary palate is actually derived from the maxillary process. So this is actually a vertical view. Vertical view means if you are just taking a section like this, how you will be seeing. We can see that there is a projection coming from above from the frontonasal process. Or we can say that the frontonasal process is actually getting thinned out and it is actually proceeding down. And we have the two maxillary processes. So if you are taking a section behind it, this is actually the frontal portion which is actually developing into face. If you take a parallel section behind, we can see that a process is actually developed from the maxilla and it is shifting medially. So this process is called palatal process of maxilla. Palatal process of maxilla. And from above we can see that the frontonasal process is actually getting thinned out, and this is actually the nasal septum. Nasal septum, and this nasal septum is trying to come down and fuse with the palatal process of maxilla, so that we will get two nasal cavities on either side. So this is a vertical view. The same view if we are taking in a horizontal aspect, what we can see, we can see the two maxillary process, and we can see two shelf-like projections which are again shifting medially. These are again the palatal process of maxilla. So this is actually a horizontal view, whereas this is actually a vertical view. So in the vertical view, we can see the nasal septum coming from above downwards and fusing with the palate. In the horizontal part, we can see anteriorly the frontonasal process, actually the fused medial nasal process, which is giving rise to the primary palate, and it is further known as the premaxilla, which includes the four incisors. And from the lateral aspect, we can see a shelf-like projection that is called the palatal process of maxilla. And ultimately, what is happening? We can see that this is a secondary palate and this is a primary palate. Both the primary and secondary palate are actually getting fused in a Y shape along a suture which is seen in the shape of a Y. So this is premaxilla, and these are the two secondary palates, that is actually the palatal process of maxilla. So the premaxilla, which is a part of primary palate, and the palatal process of maxilla, which are parts of secondary palate, fuse along a suture, which is in the form of a Y. And this actually forms the definitive palate. And what happens to the definitive palate? The mesoderm of the definitive palate undergoes intramembranous ossification, and when it ossifies, the posterior, this is the anterior portion, that is the premaxilla portion, and this is the posterior portion. Along when it reaches the posterior most portion, it won't ossify, but the rest of the part will be getting ossified to form the hard palate. The part which is remaining unossified, that will be forming the soft palate, and the posterior most portion is called the uvula, which is hanging from the soft palate. So the mesoderm of the palate will be undergoing intramembranous ossification, and the anterior most part will be ossifying to form the hard palate, and the part which is remaining unossified is forming the soft palate. And let's see some of the anomalies which can happen while it is getting fused. When the primary and secondary palate is getting fused, what are the anomalies you can expect? Sometimes the entire suture line will remain unfused, so that it will be an entire cleft palate. So the different anomalies can be named under a term, common terminology known as cleft palate. So sometimes the entire Y-shaped suture line will remain unfused, and that is complete cleft palate. Along with that, so this is the frontal portion, so you will get a bilateral hair lip as well. Now sometimes this will get fused on one part. On one part, the Y-shaped suture will get fused, but on the other side, it will be unfused, and when you go the posterior most aspect, it will remain unfused. So it is again a unilateral cleft palate. Sometimes the anterior most portion will be fused, but the remaining portion of the Y, the limb of the Y, will be unfused. Sometimes it will be restricted towards the soft palate region. The fusion, the remaining portion of the hard palate will be fused, but the portion which is seen in the soft palate will remain unfused. And again, one more anomaly which you can expect is the fusion will be defective only in the posterior most portion. So we have already named this portion as uvula. This is called uvula, and the fusion will remain unfused only in the posterior most portion, because the fusion is actually happening from the cephalic end to the caudal end. So this will remain unfused only in the posterior most part. This condition is called bifid uvula. So these are the different developmental anomalies which you can expect in the development of palate. So we'll just have a recap. Palate is derived from two parts, primary palate and secondary palate. Primary palate is derived from the fused medial nasal processes of the frontonasal process, and that is called premaxilla, which consists of four incisors. And one more point I would like to mention is the point where the premaxilla fuses with the secondary palate. This is called incisive fossa. Incisive fossa, where you have the opening of two incisive foramina. So this point is called incisive fossa. So the primary palate is derived from the premaxilla, and the secondary palate is formed by from the palatal process of the maxilla, and the primary palate and secondary palate fuse along a suture line, which is in the form of Y, to form a definitive palate. And the anomalies are different varieties of the failure of fusion along the Y-shaped suture line, which will result in cleft palate. Thank you.